All right, so just a few more examples here of evaluating trig functions at some very common angles. And again, a lot of times I think people will expect you to be able to do these for sure without a calculator. So that's kind of what we're talking about here. So again, the thing I'm going to use, the reference, kind of the thing I use, again, is I always turn it back into information. I try to relate it to the first quadrant of my unit circle. So again, to figure out cosine of 45 degrees, all I have to do is find the angle 45 degrees. I think, okay, I know the point where it hits on the circle. That would be something I would have memorized. Cosine of 45 degrees is defined to be whatever the x-coordinate is. So cosine of 45 degrees would simply be square root of 2 over 2. Nothing else to do. Okay, sine of 150 degrees. Well, 150 degrees doesn't fall in the first quadrant, so this is where I'm going to have to think about reference angles a little bit. So let's see, if we think about the angle 150 degrees, that would put us somewhere into the second quadrant. Had we gone all the way to the x-axis, we would have been at 180 degrees. So again, the reference angle is just that angle inside of the terminal ray and our negative x-axis here. So the reference angle would simply be 180 degrees minus 150 degrees, and that would give us 30 degrees. So let's see, sine of 150 degrees. The idea is I'm going to say that's equal to, I'm going to replace it, its original angle with its reference angle. But again, I need to be careful. I need to think, would this be positive or negative? Well, sine in the second quadrant, that has to do with the y-coordinate. The y-coordinates would certainly be positive in this quadrant. So sine of 150 degrees is positive. All the trig functions in the first quadrant are going to be positive. So I don't really need to change the sign or do anything different here is the main idea. Okay, so now I think, well, what is sine of 30 degrees? Well, sine of 30 degrees, I find the angle 30 degrees. I say, well, I need to know the y value. That's what the sine of 30 degrees is defined to be. So sine of 30 degrees will simply get 1/2, because that's the value of the y-coordinate. So nothing else to do there. Okay, so sine of 30 degrees is the same thing as sine of 150 degrees, which would be positive 1/2. Let's see, cosecant of 150 degrees, let's skip to part D here real quick. Remember, cosecant is defined to be 1 over sine, so cosecant of 150 degrees is equivalent to 1 over sine of 150 degrees, which would just be 1/2. And 1 divided by 1/2, that'll just flip your bottom fraction. That'll give you 2 over 1, or 2. So now we got our value for cosecant of 150 degrees. Let's do tangent of 225. Again, 225 degrees does not fall in the first quadrant, so I'm going to have to think about reference angles. All right, so let's see. If we go to the negative x-axis, that would be 180 degrees. And it looks like we would have to go another 45 degrees to get to this angle 225. And again, to find this reference angle, the reference angle, again, is just the angle inside of here. So I'm trying to figure out what its degree measure would be. Well, I can, again, simply subtract 225 degrees minus 180 degrees. That's going to give me 45 degrees. So, okay, I think, okay, in this quadrant 3, would tangent be positive or negative? And in quadrant 3, since tangent is the ratio of the y-coordinate to the x-coordinate, they would both be negative. So tangent of 225 degrees is definitely some positive number. So that's my bad notation for positive number. So again, to evaluate tangent of 225, I replace the original angle with its reference angle. And again, in the first quadrant, all the trig functions are positive by definition. So I don't have to worry about changing the sign or, you know, adding a negative or anything like that. So, okay, to figure out tangent of 45 degrees, well, recall, you know, tangent of 45 degrees is just, again, it's just the y-coordinate, it's the ratio of the y-coordinate to the x-coordinate. So tangent of 45 degrees, I do the same thing. I find my angle 45 degrees. There it is. I think, what's the point? It's root 2 over 2, comma root 2 over 2. So if I take the ratio of the y-coordinate, which is square root of 2 over 2, and divide that by the x-coordinate, which is square root of 2 over 2, well, again, you can flip and multiply and do all that, but if you have any number divided by itself, that simply gives you 1. So it turns out tangent of 225 degrees is the same thing as tangent of 45 degrees, which is just going to be positive 1.